Today I'm reviewing the Maylove Glowmaker Serum. And really quick, I just want to say I purchase all these products with my own money. So if you want to help keep the channel independent, check out my products at nobsbeauty.com and also at the Amazon link below. So this is a product I've been requested by a lot of you guys to review. So I finally got my hands on it and I'm going to review it. They also, when I went to their website to pick this up, saw several newer products that they had coming out. So I ordered a few of those too. And so in the next few weeks, I'll have more Maylove reviews. So if you're interested in the brand, stay tuned for more coming soon. So anyway, this is probably their biggest selling product, I want to say. So it's vitamin C serum. So anyway, I'm going to let you guys know my thoughts on it based on my Sarah score scale. And my first criteria is packaging, and they've done a nice job packaging this in a standard opaque dropper bottle, which they annoy me. They're hard to kind of contain. They're hard to travel with, but they're efficient and effective and affordable. So nothing wrong with that. It's just, I don't know, how do you travel with these? I don't. So I don't know, I just find other things to replace them, whatever I use that's in a dropper bottle. But anyway. My second criteria is alcohol, and this does not contain any alcohol, so denatured alcohols are not a good thing, and thankfully it doesn't have any. My third criteria is fragrance, and this is probably the only category where this product slips just a little bit with the inclusion of citrus aurantium dulcis callus culture extract, which is bitter orange, which does give the product a very light citrusy scent, which dissipates very quickly. So for the most part, most people won't have any problem with it, but if you have sensitive skin or very sensitive skin or are sensitive to fragrances, this might have to be a pass for that reason. So it's unfortunate that they included that, but nothing I can do about it. So thankfully, it's not a super high amount. It's about halfway on the ingredient list. So most people won't have an issue, but if you have sensitive skin, you might. So if possible, do a patch test or get a sample of it before you pick it up online. So anyway, so that's the only little slip up they made really with this product. So my fourth criteria is the manufacturing location, and this is made in the US, so no issues with that. My fifth criteria is ease of use, and they recommend using 4 or 5 drops over your face, neck and chest area in the morning. So you're going to want to apply any serums or essences or toners that you might use beforehand, and then use this and then follow up with another moisturizer or go straight to your sunscreen and then foundation. So this really, really works well if you apply it underneath a sunscreen. I highly recommend that. You can use this morning is what they recommend. However, I've tended to use this more so in the evening. And on days my skin feels a little bit more dry than normal because I did find this to be a more hydrating vitamin C serum, which is nice. So if you have drier skin, you could appreciate that as well. So it just has a little bit more kind of an oil type base. Well, it's a water base, but it just feels more hydrating than a lot of other ones. So, but because of that reason, I just use it in the evening, but if you have dry skin, using this under sunscreen in the morning, it'll be very easy. So it's very easy to use. So no issues with that. My sixth criteria is antioxidants. And it's got a lot of good ones in here. Vitamin C, vitamin E, ferulic acid, which those three ingredients kind of play together to make some of the best vitamin C serums I've used. Lecithin, and then grapeseed extract, which probably gives it some of that hydrating texture to it. So a lot of good beneficial ingredients. Again, this is a vitamin C serum with a shorter ingredient list, not as short as some other ones, but it's not as long as a lot of other ones out there too. So seeing a shorter list sometimes is a good thing, especially if you have sensitive skin, unless you're sensitive to orange extract. So so full of good ingredients. My seventh criteria is animal testing, and so I just found it on the Maylove website saying that they're cruelty-free. I assume that they're not selling in China, but, you know, there's always a fine line with wording. If you watch a lot of companies, the way they word that statement, You know, we don't test on animals, but if somebody else requires us to, it will be. Which, they're not cruelty-free because they're probably selling in China then. So, but from all the indicators I looked at, it doesn't seem like they're selling in China. So I do think they are cruelty-free. But if you have any other information, leave a comment. My eighth criteria is performance, and I really like this. It brightens skin. It really does a nice job hydrating skin. Never broke out with this. Some vitamin C serums can have some ingredients that are a little iffy. Vitamin E is slightly acneogenic as an ingredient, but that one is toward the end of the ingredient list. So I didn't have any issues with it, but I really thought it helped brighten my skin and hydrate it nicely. So, and then the fact that it layers well with other products and other moisturizers is nice. And sometimes I'll mix in a few drops with a moisturizer. So that works well as well. So very, very nice in terms of performance. And then my ninth criteria is the price. And this is the full size, which is 1 ounce. And it sells for $27. So for a vitamin C serum, I found that to be very reasonable. Almost in the affordable range. So there's a lot, like, what's the brand? Olay? Olay has a vitamin C product out that's $30. And this one's more affordable and probably a little bit better, so, and cruelty-free, so. And then my 10th criteria is the it factor, and they just slipped up with that orange inclusion. Had they not done that, I would have given them the it factor, but it was just a slight slip-up, but you know what? This product is so loved by so many people. I think if they probably changed the formula at all, they would probably get a little bit of a backlash, so I don't see them reformulating or changing that anytime soon. Just because so many people absolutely love it. So there's nothing wrong with that. So anyway, overall on the Sarah score scale, this got an 8 out of 10, which is pretty darn good. This one is up there in terms of a really good vitamin C serum. So I'm interested if you guys have a chance to try this out and if you have what your thoughts are, or if you've tried any of the other Maylove brand products, what have you tried and how have you liked them? So definitely let me know if there's other products from them that you like, because I'm kind of interest in the brand now. So they had a couple new products that I ordered, so I'll be reviewing those as well. But if there's another hidden gem in there, let me know. So check out nobsbeauty.com. Also check out the Amazon link below. Subscribe if you haven't already. I come with at least one new video every day. And thank you guys so much.